That's one that comes at you fast.
Yeah, you're ready to move. All right, so that was my, right, let's try it on the left. Wait, was that your right first?
Let's
see. That was your left?
Yeah, I'm doing this
way. Okay. That's what helped me, because initially I was just like spinning.
Yeah.
And there, I was more like, you know, like a, almost like a hook.
Mm-hmm.
And he was like, no, you need to get your hip, like get your foot set.
Mm-hmm.
And then from there, it's just a side kick.
Yeah, exactly.
And so that helped click. But, and then like last time we were slowing everything down, because it's like once we threw these back in, like we were going way too fast, like me and Mr. Hogan.
Oh, yeah.
And so he was like, slow down and just try to hit first. So I think that was helpful. That's all I remember.
That's good.
Yeah.
Alright, so Aiden, can you hold it again? I just want to watch one more time.
Yeah.
Okay, good. So you're already mostly doing this, but just make sure that after you punch that you're bringing it in back faster than you looked at. Because once we actually get back to sparring,
mm-hmm.
more like that exactly. Once we actually get back to sparring, you kind of leave it hanging out.
Right, that's a good point.
Yeah. And then the thing with the foot is excellent, and make sure that when you're turning around, if you have to take a second to spot it first before you lift the leg, that's okay.
Got it.
It'll help keep that leg from swinging and doing basically a double thing.
Got it.
Because you do, if it is a side kick, you do want to bring it up and push it out and bring it back in.
That's a good point. Yeah, I forgot about that. Pull it back in.
There you go. Good. Much better. All right. Can you guys put off this one?
Yes, ma'am. So many things to remember.
Good spotting. Good.
There you
good.
Go.
So the thing that might help you with your balance right there is, like, I know you want to go smoothly and you want to go fast, because that's what the move is supposed to look like. But if the turning is making you off balance, think about kind of where your head is when you're doing that. Because if you're leaning a little bit while you turn, you're going to throw yourself off. So if you punch, lunge punch, set that heel, and don't spin like you're trying to find it, just drop and twist. Mm-hmm. Try to keep your head still. And then that might help you so that you're not spinning like a top over to the side. Because
sure.
I know that's something I had a problem with coming up through the class too.
Yeah, that's a good point.
It's hard to
do. Yeah, because if your head comes around, then
yeah,
it like throws
your balance is completely off. It's hard to do. You're not going to get it right away. But just kind of be thinking about it as you practice.
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
That was actually better, yeah. That was a lot better.
Okay, keep going. I'm
going to
go get my binder.
Yes, ma'am. Let's do two more.
It's
going to
be so loud.
That was good. That was really good. One more. Yeah. Oh, here, do that kick again. Here, spot. I think you and I are doing the same thing. Like she said, like, when you're getting there, spot it, see it, Because I think your leg's coming up before your eyes are on it. I think that's what's happening. Yeah, it's like you just get it in there, but yeah. It's crazy how much ground you cover too.
Yeah.
Like, and they're not even thinking about that.
Yeah.
Especially that lunge punch.
Yeah. I mean, you cannot dodge it. I keep trying to
right.
It more and more.
Yeah, and that's crazy. Like, you know it's coming too. And it's like still like, damn, it's a lot. Yeah, at that point, they. First is probably just trying to get away.
Yeah. There's really no point. I mean, even if you know how to block it.
Yeah, you don't want to get hit by that.
Good.
Here, hold it.
Yeah, don't hold it here.
Like, move your body that way. Right here. Down here. But then, like, hold it. Yeah,
there you go.
So now there's no way I can get.
Yeah.
I just have to
go faster.
Here, let's go. So
you
use like use the line, just kind of
yeah.
Like a shuffle.
Would you like to try another one?
Yes, ma'am.
Sure. Alright. Since we're kind of working on that staying and keeping ourselves upright, you can go with this one. I'm going to embarrass myself for this camera. So, offensive front leg round kick. So offensive, of course, means that you come forward a little bit. Then back reverse side kick. Here, back leg reverse side kick. Back leg, round kick, back ridge hand. So offensive, front leg, round kick, back reverse side kick, back leg, round kick.
Back and forth.
Exactly.
Action.
So this one's similar to the lunge punch one because you're getting kind of that cyclone motion.
Mm-hmm. And then it goes.
There you go. The back leg round kick is one of my favorites to do on a heavy bag. It is so
Oh, successful. Yeah. That's a good one. Covers some ground, too.
Heck yeah. All right, so you got that defensive. Front leg round kick, back reverse side kick, back leg round kick, back hand ridge kick. Yes.
That's a good balance one.
Yes.
Everything is like tough to balance on that.
Very much so. Good. I'll hold the clapper and I'll switch off. Good. Back reverse side kick. I'm glad you remembered. Good. Okay. So for that first kick, we're in our stance. If you remember back in the previous session where we did that Bruce Lee side kick, it's kind of similar. We're bringing that foot up a little bit, but we're basically, if you do it fast enough, it's almost like a ball change. Because you're just kind of putting that foot where the other one is. And by doing it this way, you're a little bit scaring your movement to your opponent, because they don't have a clear line of sight for that leg. So it looks kind of just like you're leaning backwards a little bit. So it's to get that reach, and it's to move forward quickly. And the round kick, I'm sure you guys already know this, but the round kick is aiming for that head, and it's more of that pop. You just kind of want to pop it with the top of where your laces are, and it's meant to disorient. So when you pop up and now they're disoriented, and then the back reverse side kick is very disorienting for them because they're trying to watch your face, they're trying to watch your hand. And so the whole of the part of you that they're trying to pay attention to goes away out of their sight line. It's very confusing. So this can be very good. And then, of course, you pop them in the head. They're disoriented. Now you're grabbing them in the torso or the gut or the groin. And then from here, this is still a round kick, so you're not really getting through them like you're trying to fell a tree with your leg, but you have a lot of power and a lot of reach, especially with that back kick. You kick them and now they're further away from you. This gives you that reach, that spin round. You get it again. And then the rich hand. And when you do them in the beginner class, you do here and kind of pull back, and that's to get your speed up. If you're in a sparring situation with a rich hand, you want to past your opponent and you want to chop through their neck. Maybe because right here, when you're hitting kind of that portion of the arm, it's not a very solid portion, it's not a very strong portion by itself. It is meant to be kind of stingy and it is meant to go through them. So when you do this in actual sparring combination, you don't pop and come back like you do when you're in the beginning, punches and kicks.
Yeah. It could be. probably did more snake than I have now.
Yeah, I think it's in Leopard, but there is a move called Children Balance Buddha.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, that is meant to go for two. So in the same way with our plane basics, where we do the turnaround, the turnaround clap is meant to clap against the ear and burst the ear down. And the Children Balance Buddha is the same thing. So you're coming from here, and you're clapping. So you're coming from a little lower, because you're trying to kind of come up and surprise them. You clap up, and you're trying to pop your drum. So it's very similar, yes. Yes, it's sort of like the one-handed version of that. Well, I love it. That was very much right, yes.
The thing I've learned is the one way to file, it's pinky file.
Yeah,
yes.
Exactly.
Okay, we're a little over time with this. Let's move on to the eight diagram stack.